almost didn't see you there. Hold on.
Oh, yep. It's Friday the 13th. Hopefully you're watching this early on Patreon, and it's like Saturday the 7th. But if you're watching this on Friday the 13th, then you should know that this is going to be the Friday the 13th franchise ranked video. And it is a companion piece to the Friday the 13th franchise breakdown and ranking video that, podcast episode that I did for a Patreon and early release bonus exclusive. Thanks for watching this. I'm going to do all of the Jason movies in order from my least favorite to my favorite. So stick around. That's what we got coming up. On my list for the franchise, the Friday the 13th franchise ranking is Jason Goes to Hell. Nothing really against Jason Goes to Hell. I do like Jason Goes to Hell. I like all of the Friday the 13th movies because they're all good in their own special way. It's like you're talking about your children. But as far as the criteria that I set, which is like, how does it fit in with the other movies, personal enjoyment, and, you know, just general vibe of the movie. I think it's the most off the rails from the rest of the movies. Some would argue that that's Jason X, but they might be right, but that's like where the personal enjoyment thing comes in. I don't enjoy this one as much as I do some of the other movies that maybe are a little further removed from the canon. But yeah, that's where it lines up. Alright, next up is the 2009 Friday the 13th remake. A lot of people probably would have put this last on their list, but they would be wrong, really. I think that this movie is a great remake. I think it's the best Platinum Dunes remake that there was. I could be wrong, I don't remember exactly all of the Platinum Dunes remakes, but this is definitely one of, if not the best one they made. So I give it a lot of credit for that. It definitely has the vibe of a Friday the 13th movie, except for the fact that there are like co-survivors at the end. I feel like a Friday the 13th movie would have only had one adult survivor. but, you know, that's neither here nor there. I definitely thought it was fun and good. And Derek Mears does a great job as Jason. I mean, he almost died to bring us this movie, so that's admirable at the least, you know. But that's where it is. It's the next to the last on the list here.
Gene, this is you, baby. It's been a long time, Gina. You remember that special night we had? Remember when you took my virginity? You're sexy. You're still tight as ever. I'm gonna fucking pound you so hard. What the fuck? Shit ain't fucking right, dude. What the fuck?
All right, next up in the list, this is going to be officially getting into the top 10 here. So number 10 is Jason X. I've liked to tell people that this is my favorite Jason, but it's not. It really isn't. It is a good Jason. It gets a lot of unfair criticism and hate. People think that it's not really a good Jason movie, but come on. What the fuck? Like, Jason in space. How could you not love this? It's fantastic. It's everything you could want from a slasher movie. I don't know what Friday the 13th movies you were watching prior to this one that were like these mind-blowing films, but I must not have watched them because I feel like this one is at least on par with the rest of the franchise. It's definitely better than two other movies in the franchise, according to me. So, that's where we got it.
All set.
Good to go. Pull together, baby.
Next up is Freddy vs. Jason. I don't know, a lot of people might not have included this as a Friday the 13th movie. I feel like it's definitely more of a Friday the 13th movie than it is a Nightmare on Elm Street movie. Even though Freddy does seem to be the focal point, Jason gets a lot more kills in this movie. And the kills are done in more of a Friday the 13th style. Not sure where I fall on that, really. It does feel more like a Friday the 13th movie, but it's also still a very Elm Street also, so... but that's neither here nor there. That's another video entirely, I feel like. The reason I put it at number 9 on the list is because... basically, it's because of the reasons that, you know, you would expect. It's Freddy, it's Jason, you know, the world's colliding. Yeah, sure, it didn't live up to the hype at the time. People were expecting more of a face-off movie between the two. I really don't know exactly what the expectation was. But for me, I feel like it delivers. It's funny, it's got good fun kills in it. Freddy gets in some good one-liners. What more could you really want? It's a very fun and creative movie. The only thing I didn't like about it is I feel like I wish Kane Hodder was Jason. No disrespect to Ken Kersinger, but just something about Kane Hodder is just better.
So you're the one everyone's afraid of? Tell me something. What kind of faggot runs around in a Christmas sweater? I mean, come on, get real. You're not even scary. You're not even scary. And let's talk about the butter knives. What is with the butter knives? You trying to compensate for something? Maybe coming up a little short there between the legs, Mr. Krueger? I mean, you got these teensy weensy little things, and Jason has got this big old thing like...
All right, coming in now at number 8 is Friday the 13th Part 7, The New Blood. I really wish that I could put this one higher on the list because it is still a really good movie and it's still real fun. And I love the Jason in this one, the design of the Jason in this one. As well as it being the first time Kane Hodder played Jason. But unfortunately, this one suffers from being cut to death. Because the motion, the MPAA decided it was too gory or whatever. And like, it was supposed to, what was supposed to be the bloodiest Jason ends up being the Jason with the least blood. I would have liked to seen the original cut of the movie. Unfortunately, I don't think that that cut exists anywhere in any kind of fashion where it will ever see the day of light. So we're stuck with this version, and it's good. It's fine. It's at least better than 4 other movies. So there we go. Directed by John Carl Buechner. Definitely a fun movie still, but I would have loved to seen his original version of it.
Okay, you big hunk of a man, come and get me. Dan?
Here's where the controversy starts. Number 7, I'm putting Part 2 here at number 7. Friday the 13th, Part 2. A lot of people would rank it 1 through 4 as number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Not my opinion, not my case here. I don't think that Number two is as strong of an entry as a lot of other people do. It's real good. Still, like I said, I love all of these movies, but it is definitely not as good as some of the others that people like to shit on for some reason. But yeah, that's it. Number two is here at number seven. Vicky? Coming in at number six is one of people's favorites. This is a fan favorite. I've heard a lot of people say that it is their favorite Friday the 13th movie of all time. Obviously, it's not mine. It is still up there. It is very good. It's like Jason meets the Goonies in like a kind of way. Very fun. You know, it's more of an adventure movie than it is a slasher, which is kind of crazy. So that's why I put it there on this list. I like it, but I just wish it would have been more crazy. I feel like this one's a little more grounded with everything about it, but I don't know if grounded is even a word for any of these sequels for Jason, Friday the 13th. The most grounded probably being the first one, which is also very campy and off the wall now that you look at it in 2019. I'm sure when it came out in 1980, it was very serious and very scary. But now they're all really campy and silly. So, yeah, that's why I put Jason Lives here. So. Woo!
This is great! See, I've never driven a house before. I like this. This is great.
To the top five. Number five here is going to be Friday the 13th Part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. It has one of my favorite kills in it from the franchise, which is Julius's kill where he gets his head popped off by Jason. They have that rooftop boxing match and Jason just punches his fucking head off. It's excellent. I thought it was, this is definitely my pick for the funnest entry into the Jason franchise, the Friday the 13th franchise. but it is number 5 on the all-time as far as the best movie in the franchise goes.
Shit. Motherfucker.
All right. Number 4 here on the list is going to be Friday the 13th Part 3, the 3D one. I have the DVD and it actually comes with 3D glasses, and you have the option to watch the 3D version or the 2D version. I have yet to watch it in 3D. I'm waiting for the perfect moment, and I just have not had that perfect moment yet. I actually got to see this one on the big screen last year for Friday the 13th. It was, I think, actually in the summer last year. It was the Friday the 13th, like Jason's actual birthday. So this local theater showed it and another movie as like a double feature on Friday the 13th. This one's the one with Shelley, one of the most memorable characters in the franchise, in my opinion anyways. The prankster of the group. This one actually has a bunch of memorable characters in it because it's got the stoner couple, and it's got the biker gang people, the punks, if you will. But yeah, it's number 4 on my list, so that's where it stands.
You guys doing something I shouldn't see?
Lights working. Nice makeup job. Stop fooling around, man.
All right, top 3 time. Here we go. Number 3 is going to be Friday the 13th Part 5, The New Beginning. This one gets a lot of hate, and I think it's most people's least favorite. It's right up there with Jason X and the remake with the completely unfair amount of shit it gets. It's often called the sleaziest entry into the franchise, and maybe that's why I love it so much, because if you know me, you know that I love sleazy entertainment. Professional wrestling, which it's not as sleazy as it used to be. It's kind of like got that, it's more cleaned up and polished now, but like, whatever, it's still rooted in carnivals and, you know, trickery, so I still count it as very sleazy. I collect smut, so like any kind of things like that, it kind of tickles my fancy. So that being said, this movie is the movie from the franchise that has the best set of boobs that I've ever seen in a horror movie ever. Natural boobs, of course. There's two different separate, you got to separate natural and fake. You can't compare them side by side. But this one does have not only the most boobs of the Friday the 13th franchise, I believe, but the best with Miss Debbie Sue Voorhees. So that's why it ranks so high. It's fun. It's sleazy. Reggie the Reckless, come on. It does have, unfortunately, the worst Tommy Jarvis, but any Tommy Jarvis is better than no Tommy Jarvis.
I really love it here.
I hate it.
You know, to be perfectly honest with you, I never really chopped wood before, but it certainly looks like fun.
Leave me alone!
Here, Vic, want a bite? Here, I'll just put it over here. And later on, when you're hungry, you can have it. Well, if that's the way you feel, forget it, Vic. Just forget it. But I think you're really out of line.
All right, number two on the list is Friday the 13th, the original. The first movie in the series. I think it is possibly the most suspenseful of the movies. It's definitely it's tonally a lot different from the rest of the sequels, because this one is played a little more seriously than the sequels are. Each sequel, it seems to get more. It gets progressively more campy as it goes, and I feel like that is just a product of the times, not really as much as like a conscious decision by the filmmakers. But yeah, part one is my second favorite out of the series, and the reason why is just because I personally enjoy the more campy elements of the franchise. And this one is more serious than some of the others, but it is still really fucking good and has some of the coolest kills and the twist ending, spoiler alert, when Mrs. Voorhees is the killer is just fantastic. Plus that cool end jump scare, that last little jump scare to get you on edge and ready for the sequel. It's just perfect.
Did you know that a young boy drowned the year before those two others were killed? The counselors weren't paying any attention. They were making love while that young boy drowned. His name was Jason.
Okay, that leaves us with one last movie, Friday the 13th, Part 4, the final chapter. Needless to say, there were more after this one, so it wasn't the final chapter. I actually think Jason Goes to Hell was also called The Last Friday or The Final Friday or something like that. But they made two more Jason movies after that, so there you go. Anytime they say it's going to be the end of a horror franchise, you just kind of have to say, yeah, I'll believe it when I see it, because they're going to come back. But part four is just, I think, in my opinion, it is the culmination of what a Friday the 13th movie should be. It's got Jason, it's got good sympathetic victims, or survivors, I should say, because Tommy Jarvis and his sister are the kind of protagonist of this one. Tommy Jarvis, of course, played by Mr. Corey Feldman in this one. Big shout out to Corey Feldman for that. That is the he's my favorite Tommy Jarvis. The second favorite is Tom Matthews, and then my least favorite is the one from Part 5, which is ironically, you know, still one of my high-ranking movies. So, but yeah, Part 4 has the suspense, it has the cool kills, it has the campiness, the jokiness, has a little bit of sleaziness thrown in there. That's everything you want from a Friday the 13th movie is in Part 4. And I think that you can really tell that they intended to end it there. And of course it just didn't, because Friday the 13th was going to make them money. And that's why they wanted to make more movies, so they could make more money off of it. So of course they did. But as far as I'm concerned, Friday the 13th Part 4, the final chapter, is the perfect Friday the 13th movie. So that's why it's number one.
Hey! Ted! Ted! Hey, Ted, where the hell's Corkscrew?
Jimmy?
Thanks for watching, y'all. As always, make sure you join us on Patreon so you can get these videos early. You get the podcast episodes early. The higher up tiers, you even get bonus episodes. Some of them even have physical goods you can get. That's patreon.com/Martell's Movie Madness. The more patrons I have on Patreon, the more quality content I can put out. So go ahead and go join that. If you want more quality content, make sure you rate, review, and subscribe wherever you're listening to the show. Subscribe to us here on YouTube. Give us a thumbs up if you like the video. Leave us a comment. Let us know what kind of videos you want to see in the future. I think that's all I got. Thanks for watching. Now, let's watch some fucking movies.